So in module 3, here we are going to study for three winding transformers and cooling methods of transformers. So first we will see three winding transformer concept. Okay. So in two winding transformers, there will be two types of windings. Which are those? Primary winding and secondary winding. And if you take auto transformer, there will be only one single winding. And now in three winding transformers, there will be three different types of windings will be there. The already two known windings are the same, that is primary and secondary winding. Apart from primary and secondary winding, the third winding, which we use it for some purpose in power system, that winding we call it as tertiary winding. That is called as tertiary winding. Okay, so if the transformer is having three windings, then that type of the transformer we call it as three winding transformers. Okay, let us see the introduction part here. In addition to primary and secondary windings, the transformers may be constructed with the third winding. Okay, apart from primary and secondary winding, we can also have one more extra third winding in the transformer. Okay, this winding is called tertiary winding. It is called as tertiary winding. The normal two winding transformer can be converted into three winding transformer with an additional secondary winding having number of turns as per the requirements. No doubt already we have seen there are two windings, that is primary and secondary. Apart from that primary and secondary, if I want to have one more extra tertiary winding, that one more extra tertiary winding, it is also called as another secondary winding. Already one secondary winding will be there. Apart from that, one more secondary winding, if I am going to include into my transformer part, then that one more secondary winding, we call it as tertiary winding. And such transformer, we call it as three winding transformers. If a transformer has three windings, that is primary winding, secondary winding and tertiary winding, then that type of transformer we call it as three winding transformers. Okay, now let us see why we are going to make use of tertiary winding. What is its necessity? Sometimes in the examination they may ask the question, what is the necessity of tertiary winding? Why we are going to make use of tertiary winding in power system? Okay, now let us see what are the reasons why we are going to make use of tertiary winding in the transformer. Okay, so you can see here, there are many reasons for which three winding transformers is employed. Some of the reasons are listed below. Let us see here. First one, if a two winding transformer has to supply an additional load, which has to be insulated from the secondary windings for some reasons, then three winding transformer may be used with additional load carried by tertiary winding. So say for example you are having two loads and both those loads should be supplied by the same transformer, right? So load one, it is connected directly to the prior secondary winding, which is supplied from 230 volts, say for example. And if there is one more second load which wants to be supplied from the same transformer, and that too from the some other voltage which is separate from 230. If it is not in the requirement of 230, it may want some other voltage like 150 volts. Then in that case, what I can do, I am going to connect that load to, or second load to, the tertiary winding, which will supply the power to the second load with 150 volts, that too from the same transformer. So whenever the load requirement is having the voltage requirements which is different from the secondary winding voltage, then in that case we are going to make use of tertiary winding or three winding transformers. Okay, the second reason is phase compensating devices can be supplied with three winding transformers which are operating at either primary or secondary voltage but at some different voltage levels. So here see that phase compensating is what? In power system, phases will be changing as per the loading condition. So if I want to balance the phase of the power system parameters like voltage and current, so there we are going to make use of phase compensating devices. So those phase compensating devices, they want voltages some other different from the primary or secondary voltage. So in that case, your tertiary winding, it is going to supply the power for the phase compensating device. So to supply the power for the phase compensating device, there also we are going to make use of three winding transformer. Is it clear, all of you? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Third one is tertiary winding can be used as a voltage coil in a testing transformer. So in high voltage systems and all, we are going to have one testing transformer. So that testing transformer, it is going to make use of three winding transformer, which is going to act as a voltage coil. Your tertiary winding, it is used as a voltage coil, and that too in the testing transformer, just to check the high voltage equipments. Okay, it is going to be used as a voltage coil in testing transformer, tertiary winding. Fourth one, three supply systems operating at different voltages can be interconnected using three winding transformer. You can see here, there are three supply systems, supply system 1, supply system 2, supply system 3, and all the three are, they are operating at different voltage levels. And since they are operating at different voltage levels, and if I want to interconnect to all the three systems, then that interconnection can be made possible by making use of three winding transformers. Okay, then the three winding transformer can be used to load large split winding generators. So see here, we can also give the power supply, or we can also load the generators where its windings is split into large sections, where its winding is split into large sections. So in generally, three winding transformers, they are used to supply the generators, they are used to load the generators whose windings are split in large manner, whose windings are split in large manner. Okay, then sixth requirement is substation requirements can be met using three winding transformer, which requires a voltage from that of primary and secondary winding. So in substation, it is not that all the time we want the voltages as per given by the primary or secondary winding. For some other purpose, I want the voltage which is different from primary and secondary winding. So such different voltages, which is different from primary and secondary winding voltage, I can get it from tertiary winding. For a battery store, what is that, charging purpose and all, in the substations, there we are going to make use of tertiary winding for the voltage levels which is different from primary and secondary winding. Okay, then seventh requirement, let us see here. Tertiary winding connected in delta reduces the impedance offered to the zero sequence currents, so a large earth fault current flows for proper operation of protective equipment. So this sentence is a bit confusing for you people. Let me explain this sentence clearly. Usually what happens is that in the power system, we are using certain protective devices. Protective devices means what? Like for example, in the household application, for the protection of TV, refrigerator, we are using what? Some simple switches, fuses and voltage stabilizer. Yes or no? But in large voltage, like high voltage systems, in substations and all, they, the protective devices will be like, what is that, relays and circuit breakers. For high voltage system, we are using relay and circuit breakers. But for single phase 213, for household application purpose, we are using simple MCB, fuse or any kind of voltage stabilizer and all for protection purpose. But if you are playing with the high voltages, there we are using what? Relay and circuit breaker. So what is this relay and what is the circuit breaker? So whenever fault occurs in the power system, that fault should not flow to the next section, which is healthier. Yes or no? If the fault current, which is very large in manner, if it is going to flow through the healthy section, then the healthy section gets disturbed. For that sake, what we are doing is that we are using certain protective devices in power system, which we call it as relay and circuit breaker. So what is the operation function of relay and what is the function of circuit breaker? Is relay, it is going to sense to the fault condition, because a relay will be knowing up to this much amount of voltage and this much amount of current, it is the healthy condition in the power system. If any conditions beyond these parameters, if it is going to cross, then that is faulty condition. So during fault condition, obviously voltage will be less, current will be more. So that mismatch in the preset conditions, it will make the relay to operate. Yes, that will make the relay to operate. It senses that some fault has been taken place now. So that sensing capacity to the relay, it is possible only when certain conditions to be met. Those conditions like it should carry enough amount of the current through its coil so that it can send the tripping signal to the associated circuit breaker. But now, if opposition to the flow of the current to the relay is more, then relay is not going to operate. Yes or no? Even though fault has been taken place, if opposition or impedance is more for the relay current, then relay will not operate. If relay is not operating, then it is not going to send the actuating command signal for the circuit breaker. Then even though fault has been taken place, circuit breaker will not operate. It will not trip. If circuit breaker is not going to trip, then automatically what will happen? The fault current, it will enter into the next healthy section where it is going to bring all the healthy section into shutdown system. Yes. So to avoid this kind of the things, what is the thing we are going to do? To make enough amount of current to flow through the relay during faulty condition, on the kind of connection what we are using is tertiary winding. We are using that too in the delta fashion, that too in the delta fashion in the relays, so that the relay will easily allow the zero sequence component. Zero sequence means usually the current, it is divided into three components: positive sequence, negative sequence and zero sequence. And during fault condition, this zero sequence currents will be flowing in the secondary side of the transformer, and that too in the relay part. If the opposition is more for this zero sequence current which are flowing through the relay, then relay will not operate. If relay is not operating, circuit breaker will not open. So for that sake, what this tertiary winding, which will do tertiary winding, usually it will be connected in delta fashion. Delta means what? It is as good as closed loop. So that closed loop, what it will do? It will provide very less impedance. It will provide very less opposition for the zero sequence currents, and current can easily flow through the relay. And now relay is going to carry the faulty current, then accordingly it is going to make the decision to trip the circuit breaker. Is it clear? So tertiary winding in delta reduces the impedance offered to the zero sequence currents, so a large earth fault current flows for the proper operation of protective equipments. Okay, also you can see here, for unbalanced load, it limits the imbalance in voltage. So if we apply some unbalanced load, so that unbalanced loading condition, it is going to introduce some unbalanced parameters like voltage may change, current may change, frequency may change. So all these unbalanced loading conditions will be taken care and it is made into balanced condition by the help of tertiary winding. Okay, it permits the flow of third harmonic current to reduce third harmonic voltage. So usually third harmonic voltage we should not have into the power system network. So this third harmonic voltage will be suppressed by allowing third harmonic current to be flown through the system. So if it is going to permit the flow of third harmonic current by offering less amount of the impedance, then third harmonic voltage will be suppressed. This is the meaning. Okay, let us see the now. The third winding, known as tertiary winding, is generally connected in delta. It is usually connected in delta fashion. Okay, thus when any fault or short circuit occurs on the primary or secondary side, there will be large unbalance of phase voltage. If any fault occurs, then automatically there is a unbalance in the phase voltage, which is compressed by the large tertiary winding circulating current. So this will be compressed by what? Tertiary winding circulating current. Okay, then reactance of the tertiary winding must be such to limit the circulating current to that which can be carried by copper in order to avoid overheating of tertiary winding under fault condition. I told you that these tertiary winding, how they are connected? They are connected in delta fashion and they are going to offer very less amount of the impedance to the flow of the zero sequence current or fault current. But see that the reactance of the tertiary winding should have some heat bearing capacity. Means what? Tertiary winding, it is made up of copper, so whenever some large current is going to be flown through that winding, then it is going to occur some copper losses. Those copper losses will increase the heat, and that heat should be easily carried or it should be withstanded by the tertiary winding very safely. To that level, its reactance should be designed. This is the meaning. Okay, so this is all about why we are going to make use of tertiary winding. So can you tell me on the basic requirement for tertiary winding one by one? Now after seeing all these requirements, just to tell me for what purpose we are using tertiary winding now or three winding transformer.
To supply different ratings of voltage, and it is arranged in delta fashion, it can balance the unbalanced conditions of the loads.
Yes. Then it is going to meet the voltage levels which is different from primary and secondary, and also it is used to interconnect the three systems which are operating at different voltages. And if the load requires some other voltage which is different from primary and secondary winding voltage, then there also I can make use of tertiary winding. So altogether, in general, what I can say, tertiary winding is that transformer which we are using it for the supply of voltage which is different from primary and secondary voltage. If you want voltage levels which is different from primary and secondary, then make use of tertiary winding transformer. And also this tertiary winding, it is connected in delta fashion in protective system, where this will offer very less amount of the impedance to the fault current, that is zero sequence components can be easily flown through the relay, and by that time and the relay can make the trip into the circuit breaker. Okay, so this is all about tertiary winding requirements. Now let us see the important concept. Usually in the final examination they will ask, explain how stabilization can be achieved by tertiary winding. Explain how stabilization can be achieved using tertiary winding. This is usually the most repeated question in the final exam for 5 marks. Okay, so now let us see. You can see how many windings are there here. Primary winding, secondary winding, safe. This is tertiary winding. Primary winding, secondary winding, tertiary winding. How they are connected? What is the type of connection?
Delta fashion, sir.
This connection. Just check the flow of this cursor.
Star
connected in star. Okay, so now initially we are trying to say that stabilization is achieved because of tertiary winding, that too by the delta connection and not by the star connection. Let us see what happens if the tertiary winding is connected in star. And because of the drawbacks associated with the star connection, then we will be switching over to the, what is that, delta connection. And because of the delta connection, what is the advantage we are going to achieve? Let us see that. Okay, so remember, this is one of the important repeatedly asked question in the final exam for 5 marks. The question will be like, with a neat explain how stabilization can be achieved using tertiary winding. For 5 marks it will be asked. Okay, now let us see the description here. For unbalanced single phase load, the star-star connection offers high reactance to the flow of current. So as I told you, whenever fault occurs, how many components will be there in the fault current? Three components: zero sequence, positive sequence and negative sequence, right? So now out of the three, the important for us is zero sequence component, which is flowing through the protective device like relay. And now what is going to happen if the system is connected in star? So if the three winding transformer, it is connected in star star, then this star star connection offers high reactance, means high opposition it is going to be offered to the flow of current, to the flow of current in the sense to the flow of zero sequence component which is flowing through the relay. Okay, any unbalanced load currents has three components, that is positive, negative and zero sequence component. Okay, the zero sequence component on the secondary side cannot be balanced by primary. So we'll try to understand, zero sequence component, which is the part of the fault current, it is on the secondary side. On this side, this current cannot be balanced from the primary side. No, it cannot be balanced by primary side currents, as zero sequence currents cannot flow in the isolated neutral of the star connected primary. So suppose here zero sequence currents are flowing, means these zero sequence currents cannot be balanced by the primary, because this primary side is completely isolated, it is having isolated neutral, it is having separate neutral. Because of that, the zero sequence components which are present on the secondary side, that too in the star connection, that cannot be balanced by the primary side, whose neutral is completely separated, whose neutral is completely isolated. Okay, on the secondary side, the zero sequence current sets up magnetic flux in the core. So whenever zero sequence currents will be flowing on the secondary side, obviously the current is going to set up the flux because of the magnetic path, because of the magnetic path or the core. Okay, the iron path is available for this flux. So since currents are flowing, then flux will be generated because of the iron path. And now let us see what is the problem. What is the problem that is experienced by the flux? The iron path is available for this flux, and the impedance offered to the zero sequence currents is very high. So whenever zero sequence currents are flowing on the secondary side, that too in the star-star fashion, the zero sequence current, it will produce its own flux, but the flux is experiencing high impedance, high opposition because of the high reactance. Okay, but if the delta connected tertiary winding permits the, but whereas delta connected tertiary winding permits circulation of zero sequence currents in it. So see here, if the tertiary winding, it is connected in delta fashion, what is the type of connection here? This circuit diagram, how it is connected now? Earlier it is in the star, and now it is connected in, and now it is connected in what fashion? In delta system. So in the delta system, this I naught indicates zero sequence current, which is a part of your fault current. Are you getting? So this is the part of the fault current which has to be sensed by the protective device to avoid the damage to the power system. Okay, so now this fault current, which is having zero sequence component, it can be made easily to flow through the delta connected tertiary winding. Okay, but the delta connected tertiary winding permits circulation of zero sequence currents in it, so impedance offered to the flow of zero sequence currents is lowered. Because if it is allowing for the zero sequence currents to flow through, means it is having less impedance, it is having less impedance. If it is connected in star fashion, then it is having high impedance. Because of that, zero sequence components which are present on the secondary side cannot be balanced by the primary side, whose neutral is isolated. So what we are doing, we are connecting the tertiary winding in delta. Because of that, zero sequence currents can be flown very easily, that too with low impedance, that too with low impedance. Okay, for this purpose, tertiary winding is called stabilizing winding. So what it will do, it will allow or it will carry the zero sequence component. Since it is carrying the fault zero sequence component through it, it is going to balance the things here. So initially, what is the problem we are facing here? Some unbalance has been.
What is, yes, zero sequence component?
Yeah, you will learn by the time when you go to the sixth semester subject called as power system analysis one. So in the power system analysis one, there you are going to see the things like, if whenever fault in the power system is going to take place, then that fault current is having three components: positive sequence, negative sequence, and zero sequence. Okay, so now I am analyzing this concept with the help of fault current. So why this fault has taken place? Fault has been taken place because of unbalanced condition. Unbalanced means what? Here I will apply 1 kilowatt, 1 kilowatt, and for any one of the winding I may apply 2 kilowatt. So this unbalanced loading on the primary, on the secondary side, what it will do? It is going to introduce some unbalanced parameters like unbalanced voltages and unbalanced currents. So these unbalanced parameters, it will generate what? Fault. And that fault current, it will be having three components: primary, what is it, positive sequence, negative sequence, and zero sequence. And for us, zero sequence component is important. Zero sequence is the part of your fault current. Understand, it is a part of your or component of the fault current. And this zero sequence component, it is going to allow, it is going to help for the relay to operate, or it is going to stabilize the entire system. Why? What it is going to do? This unbalanced zero sequence component, whenever it is made to flow through the tertiary winding, then this tertiary winding, it is going to balance the things which is earlier unbalanced because of unbalanced loading condition. Are you getting? It is the component of the fault current. Fault current, it is having three components, positive, negative, and zero sequence. So this zero sequence is important for us. So what this zero sequence will do? Say for example, in your home you are using some fuse. you are using fuse. What is that fuse is having? Fuse, what is the component it is using?
Insulating material.
Yes. What will be there? Will be there in the fuse. If you take fuse wire, have you seen? Yes. If you take small fuse, say for example in the voltage stabilizer or in the fuse is simply a element which will be connected in series to protect some household appliances like TV, refrigerator and all. Yes or no? So whenever high current because of the fault is going to take place, that fuse will be having its own current carrying capacity, safe carrying current carrying capacity. Say for example, I will say 2 ampere. Up to 2 ampere is the safe current carrying capacity. Then suppose whenever fault is going to take place, then what will be the current? Will it be 2 ampere or it will be more than 2 ampere?
More than 2 ampere.
So that more than 2 ampere current, how it is going to safeguard the refrigerator or TV? How it is going to provide the protection? Because of high current. High current, what it will do? High current will be flowing because of that copper wire. Wire is made up of copper usually or tin lead alloy. So it is going to produce the huge amount of copper losses. Copper loss means what? I square R losses. I square R losses, how it will be appearing physically? In the form of heat. So that heat, it will break the wire. It will fuse the wire. Are you getting my point? So their automatic breaking of the circuit is going to take place. Yes? Are you getting? But if it is a high voltage system in substations and all, there how you are going to understand which is normal condition and which is abnormal condition or fault condition? It is all because of some conditions we should study. We are going to preset. These are all the required parameters for fault condition. These are all the required parameters for safe condition. If any values goes beyond safe condition values, then circuit breaker and associated relay should operate. So that relay and circuit breaker will come into picture whenever it is with respect to high voltage protection. But in the household application and all, we are using simply fuse. So here fuse will automatically melt and it is going to give the protection. But there in the high voltage systems, we are usually using relay. So whenever fault is going to take place, that fault current which is having the zero sequence component current, that zero sequence current component should be made to flow through the relay. If that current is experiencing huge amount of the impedance, then relay will not operate. If relay is not operating, then it will not send the command signal for the associated circuit breaker. Where circuit breaker will not open, then if circuit breaker will be intact, means then fault current will enter into the healthy section also. Healthy section will be having so many things connected to it, all those things will be getting damaged. Getting? So here this zero sequence component, which is very important for us to balance the system from the unbalanced condition or to operate the relay in the protective system, this will be made easier if the tertiary winding is connected in delta fashion. this tertiary winding connected in delta fashion will allow the zero sequence component to flow through. Because of that, relay will operate. Because of that, unbalanced loading condition will be getting balanced. This is how tertiary winding, which is connected in delta fashion, will offer very less impedance to the flow of the zero sequence component. Because of that, system gets balanced. But if it is connected in star fashion, then the star fashion will offer huge impedance. Because of that, zero sequence component will not flow through the relay, and relay will not sense the fault, and the fault will be allowed to flow through the next healthy section. This is how system gets interrupted, or system gets damaged because of the things connected in star connection. Is it clear? Because of this, we say that tertiary winding is acting as a stabilizing winding if it is connected in delta fashion. Is it clear? And remember, zero component means it is the component of fault current. Fault current is having three components: positive sequence, negative sequence, and zero sequence. And zero sequence is important for us here. That zero sequence, what it will do, it will flow through the relay and it will operate the relay. If relay is operated, then it is going to send the signal to the circuit breaker to open. Is it clear? Yes. So in the examination, you need to write all this description and you need to draw this diagram. Only this much if you write, then it is sufficient for you to get 4 to 5 marks. Yes. And also, I have given this question in your assignment, second assignment. Have I given this question? Have you written the assignment? Those who have seen the assignment questions, you will answer to my question now. Okay. Is this clear?
Yes, sir, you have given this question.
Okay. So this concept, is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us see the equivalent circuit of three winding transformer. So far we have seen equivalent circuit for which type of transformers? Yes.
Single phase and auto transformer.
We have seen, firstly we have studied equivalent circuit for two winding transformer, and those equivalent circuit parameters, how they are estimated? Using OC and AC test. Yes or no? Equivalent circuit parameters are, which are they? Like R naught, X naught, IM, IC, R1E, X1E, Z1E. Yes or no? All these are the equivalent circuit parameters, where some of the parameters will be determined using OC test and some of the parameters will be determined by AC test in case of two winding transformer. Similarly, we also seen equivalent circuit of auto transformer also, only single winding. And now we will see equivalent circuit of three winding transformer. Here we will be given it three windings. Which are those three windings? Let us see here. So this will be my primary winding, which is denoted as 1, and this will be my secondary winding, which is denoted as 2, and this will be my tertiary winding, which is denoted as 3. So here the nomenclature is like 1 for primary, 2 for secondary, 3 for tertiary. And associated impedance is Z2 of the secondary winding. Associated impedance of tertiary is Z3. Associated impedance of primary is Z1. And it will be having impedance means what? It is a combination of what?
Resistance and reactance.
Reactance. Very good. So primary winding will be having its own resistance and reactance, which is represented by the impedance Z1. Secondary winding will be having its own resistance and reactance, represented by impedance Z2. Tertiary will be having its own resistance and reactance, denoted by impedance Z3. And here we can connect the load for the second, for the tertiary winding. Similarly, here also I can connect the load to the secondary winding. So there is a one more common connection, which is common for all primary winding, secondary winding, and tertiary winding. So the voltage available across with respect to tertiary winding to the what is that common point? This we call it as voltage V3. Voltage available with respect to secondary winding and with respect to common is voltage V2. Voltage available across primary with respect to common is V1. here all the three voltages are different from each other. Okay, I can connect the load to the tertiary, also I can connect the load to the secondary also. Now let us see how to determine the equivalent circuit parameters. So here also, once again, we are going to conduct OC and SC test only. But the way how we are going to conduct the OC and SC test and how we are going to utilize those results for calculation of the latest equivalent circuit parameters, let us see. Okay. While drawing the equivalent circuit of three winding transformer, each of the winding is represented by its equivalent resistance and reactance. So each winding is primary winding, it is represented by its equivalent resistance and reactance, which is denoted as impedance Z1, impedance Z2, impedance Z3. The exciting current is neglected. So here, exciting branch means what? Yes, what is exciting branch? Magnetizing branch. So here, magnetizing branch is neglected. Here, magnetizing branch is neglected. Just we have taken primary, secondary, and tertiary winding. Okay. All the parameters are reduced to a common rating base. So all these parameters, they are measured with respect to one common base. So this is the common baseline, common rating base and respective voltage basis. Respective voltage basis means V2 is the voltage of secondary with respect to common. V3 is the voltage of tertiary with respect to common. V1 is the voltage of primary with respect to common. Okay. The circuit is simplified by neglecting the exciting branch. So here, exciting branch, which is having R0 and X0, IM, IC, I0, all those things we have neglected here, okay, to make the things more easier. The division of the load currents, the division of the loads between secondary and tertiary is arbitrary. So here, I can connect the load to the secondary also, I can connect the load to this tertiary also, and it is arbitrary, it is not constant, it will be keeps on changing as per our requirement. Okay, then external circuits are respectively connected between 1, 2, and 3 and the common terminals. So whatever the things, if you want to do it externally connection, then we can connect to 1 and common 2 and common, in between 3 and common. That is the meaning, loads I mean to say. This side we are going to energize it, this side we are going to connect the load. Okay, now as exciting current is neglected, so here no load current or magnetizing branch I0 is neglected. So in this case, primary current, how it is distributed? So at this node, if I apply the KCL, I1 is equal to what? Here, if suppose current I2 is flowing and here current I3 is flowing, then it will be just like I1 is equal to I1 plus I2. But here, because of the exciting current is neglected, because of that, say we are saying that all the three currents I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to 0 because of the condition exciting current I0 is neglected. Otherwise, it will be like I1 is equal to I2 plus I3. I1 is equal to I2 plus I3. Okay. Now, how to determine these impedances? How to get the value of Z2? How to get the value of Z3? How to get the value of Z1? Z1 means impedance of primary, Z2 means impedance of secondary, Z3 means impedance of tertiary. How to get these values? These values will be obtained by making use of short circuit test and open circuit test. Let us see the things how to get Z1, Z2, Z3 using short circuit test now. Okay. The determination of impedance in the above circuit, equivalent circuit, is carried out from three simple short circuit tests. So here, to determine the values, we are simply using some short circuit test, three different short circuit tests. How those tests will be conducted, let us see. Let Z12, what is this Z12? Z12 means it is the impedance of Z1 and Z2. Z12, only these two impedances I am going to short it. Z12 means I am going to short terminal 2 with terminal 1, keeping Z3 open. This we are, I am going to leave it. Just I'm going to short with the help of wire. I will connect one terminal wire to terminal 1, another end to the terminal 2, keeping Z3 open. Then that is called as Z12. Z12 is equal to short circuit impedance of windings 1 and 2 with winding 3 open. Similarly, Z23. What is this Z23? short circuit impedance of winding 2 and 3 with winding 1 open. Z23 means I will short 2 and 3 winding with winding 1 open. This I am going to keep it open. Simply I will short 2 and 3. Then that we call it a short circuit impedance of winding 2 and 3. Similarly, Z13. Z13 means what? Short circuit impedance of winding 1 and 3 with winding 2 open. Winding 2 open means what? I am going to short terminal 1 with terminal 3, keeping winding 2 open. Is it clear, all of you? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, all the impedances are referred to a common base from the equivalent circuit. So, if we take this common, all these impedances, they are with respect to the common reference base. Now, Z12. What is this Z12? Short circuit impedance between 1 and 2 with winding 3 open. Whichever is not there here, that will be open. Here, which is not there? Only 2 and 3 is there. 1 is not there. So, winding 1 is open. Here, which winding is not there?
Winding 2.
Winding 2 is absent. So, second is open, whereas 1 and 3 are shorted. So, now the value of Z12 is equal to what here? Z1 plus Z2. So, Z12 means I will short 1 with 2. How they are appearing? They are appearing in the form of series. For that sake, we will write Z12 as Z1 plus Z2. Similarly, Z23 means what? Z2 plus Z3. Z13 means Z1 plus Z3. All they are appearing in the form of series here. So, Z12 is equal to Z1 plus Z2. Z23 is equal to Z2 plus Z3. Z13 is equal to Z1 plus Z3. Okay. So, call this as equation 1, this as equation 2, and this as equation number 3. Now, subtracting equations 2 and 3. So, which is my equation 2? Equation 2 is Z23 and equation 3 is Z13. So, subtract these two equations. Subtract Z13 from equation Z23. So, Z23 minus Z13. What is Z23? Z2 plus Z3 minus of Z1 plus Z3. Z1 plus Z3 means like terms are what? Z3 and Z3 will cancel. You are left out with simply Z2 minus Z1. So Z23 minus Z13 is Z2 minus Z1, and now you call this as equation number 4. Now, once again, you subtract this equation number 4 from equation number 1. See here, subtracting equation 4 and 1 means from equation number 4, you subtract equation number 1. So what is my equation number 4? Equation number 4 is Z23 minus Z13. Minus of equation 1 is Z12. Okay. Now, what is the value of Z23 minus Z13? That is Z2 minus Z1. That is Z2 minus Z1 minus of Z12. Z12 is nothing but Z1 plus Z2. So, now you open all the brackets. So, now Z2 and this Z2 plus Z2 minus Z2 will be getting cancelled. This is minus Z1. This is minus Z1. So, you are left out is simply minus 2 times of Z1. So, now Z23 minus Z13 minus Z12 is equal to minus 2 times of Z1. So, rearrange the terms. From this, you get the value for Z1. So, Z1 is equal to, after simplifying the equation, Z1 is equal to half of Z12 plus Z13 minus Z23. So, impedance Z1. So, this impedance Z1 is nothing but what? The value of Z1 is equal to half of Z12 plus Z12 plus Z13 minus Z23, because this is not there. This is not there. So this you can subtract it. So Z1 is equal to half of Z12 plus Z13 minus of Z23. Z1 is equal to half of Z12 plus Z13 minus Z23. On the same lines, now you tell me how to get the value of Z2. Make use of same equation. How to get the value of secondary winding impedance Z2? Yes? Just follow the same equation. Z2 can be written as what? Half of Z21.
Z13.
Yes.
Half of Z21.
Yes.
plus Z23 minus Z13.
Very good. Right. So Z2 is equal to half of which is there now, that you should take it as common. Z23 plus Z12 or Z21, both are same, minus of Z13. This is not there, no? Only second is there. So 1 and 3 are not there. So you subtract it. Similarly, Z3 is equal to half of Z13 plus Z23 minus of Z12. Minus of Z12. So here we have estimated the values of each and every winding impedance, that is Z1, Z2 and Z3. How we have estimated? By making use of SC test. And now the remaining equivalent circuit parameters of magnetizing branch. Magnetizing branch means what? Parameters like R0, X0, ICIM and all those things we are going to estimate it using which test? If these things we are getting from SC test, means those equivalent circuit parameters of magnetizing branch we are getting from, which is another test?
Open circuit.
OC test.
OC test. Okay. So you can see here the open circuit test can be performed on any one of the three windings. On any one of the three windings. This helps in obtaining the core losses, co-magnetizing impedance and turns ratio. Okay. So the rest of the things belonging to what? Magnetizing branch or core losses branch. It will be obtained from the open circuit test. Is it clear, all of you? So this is all about equivalent circuit of three winding transformer. So to calculate the equivalent circuit of the three winding transformer, we are considering three different impedances on a common baseline, and we are going to conduct SC test as OC test. So Z1 is equal to half of Z12 plus Z13 minus of Z23. Similarly, Z2 is equal to half of Z12 plus Z23 minus of Z13. Similarly, Z3 is equal to half of Z31 plus Z32 or Z23 minus of Z12. Is it clear? Yes. If they ask in the exam, till here you are supposed to write in the exam with a neat sketch, explain the equivalent circuit of what is that? Three winding transformer. Then you should derive this expression. Yes. Now, shall I move to the last topic of advantage and disadvantage of three winding transformer now?
Okay, sir.
So advantage and disadvantage means here, whatever the requirements we have seen in the beginning, they are going to become the advantage of three winding transformer. The same thing. Let us see the advantages first. So advantage of three winding or tertiary winding transformer are as given below. First one, it can supply additional load providing insulation from the secondary winding. So here for the same, here I can connect one more load. This is my tertiary winding. Here I can connect one more load which is isolated from the secondary winding, which is insulated from the secondary winding. That is an advantage. Then it can act as a source of voltage at substation to meet the internal load demand of substation, which is a different voltage that either of primary or secondary voltage level. As I told you, if I want any voltage beyond or different from primary and secondary in the substations, then we can make use of tertiary winding. Okay. Then the reactive power injection into the system is possible for voltage control by connecting synchronous condensers or static capacitor to the tertiary winding. So here in the beginning I told you, what is that? Phase compensating devices can be supplied. Phase compensating device means here, these are the devices which are going to adjust the phase or improve the power factor. So those power factor improving devices or phase compensating devices are nothing but capacitors or synchronous condensers. So the power for the capacitors or synchronous condensers, which are nothing but the phase compensating devices, it will be given with the help of tertiary winding. So it can act as a source of voltage. It can act as a source of voltage at substation to meet the, the reactive power injection into the system. Reactive power means the phase compensating devices, it requires reactive power. It requires reactive power, and the phase compensating devices will be like capacitors or synchronous condensers. So these capacitors are static capacitors, which are nothing but the phase condensers. They want reactive power, and to give the reactive power or to inject the reactive power, we are using tertiary winding. This tertiary winding will act as a source of voltage, which will give the reactive power for the phase compensating devices like capacitors or synchronous condensers. Okay, these are just going to balance the phase. They are phase advancers, or they are called as power factor improvement devices. Then fourth advantage is a delta connected tertiary winding offers less impedance to the flow of zero sequence currents. Very well known to all of you now. So this delta connected tertiary winding offers very less amount of the impedance to the flow of zero sequence current, thus allows larger earth fault current to flow through the protective device, facilitating its proper operation. So here, if any fault is going to take place, so the fault is like earth fault, if it is going to take place, then that fault current can be made to flow through easily through the protective device. Protective device means a relay here. It is a relay, R-E-L-A-Y, relay, okay? It is relay. And because of the operation of the relay, then subsequent action can be taken for, what is that, protection purpose. Then it reduces voltage unbalance under unbalanced loading conditions and permits third harmonic current to flow, which reduces third harmonic voltages. As I told you, it is going to balance the unbalanced loading conditions. Unbalanced loading conditions, how it is going to balance it? Just by permitting third harmonic current. Third harmonic current means that is nothing but zero sequence component. It is going to offer very less amount of the impedance for the third harmonic component. Because of that, voltage, third harmonic voltage gets suppressed and system becomes balanced. Then three transmission lines at different voltage levels can be interconnected by using three winding transformers. So here, if three systems are operating at three different voltage levels, then such kind of the systems can be interconnected with the help of tertiary winding or three winding transformer. And then three winding transformer, usually called tertiary winding, can be used to serve purpose of measuring voltage of high voltage testing transformers. So for high voltage purpose also, I can make use of this tertiary winding as a voltage coil. So this voltage coil, whenever we are going to use for some measuring purpose or for testing purpose, then that voltage coil, it is made up of this tertiary winding only. So tertiary winding has the capacity to act as a high voltage winding or a testing winding. Is it clear? So all these are nothing but advantages of three winding transformer. Advantages and requirements are almost one and the same. Is it clear? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Then coming to the disadvantage part now. Now let us see the disadvantage. The disadvantage of three winding transformer is its construction is little bit complicated as compared to normal two winding transformers. So usually if one more extra additional winding will be present, means its construction becomes complicated. Why? Because you need to isolate secondary winding from the tertiary winding. Some extra insulation it requires. It requires some alterations in the design part and all. So because of all those things, system becomes complicated. Then a separate third winding is required to be placed, which requires more copper, and hence cost of the third three winding transformer is obviously more. So here, apart from primary and secondary winding, you need to have one more third winding, separate third winding in your transformer. Because of that, and winding is made up of copper, because of that, automatically cost is of the transformer is going to be increased. Because windings, they are made up of copper, means the cost of copper is more. Because of that, it is going to increase in the cost of the transformer. Okay. The core of the transformer has to carry three windings instead of two, as in case of normal two winding transformer. Usually core, it will be carrying two windings. Usually it will be carrying two windings, that is primary and secondary. But now the extra burden for the core is it has to carry even tertiary windings also. So core is under the burden now. So it is going to experience burden. So these are all the disadvantages. Majorly the disadvantage is what? Construction, because of extra winding. because of the extra winding, extra copper is required. Because of that, cost is going to be increased, and also core is has to carry three windings now, that is primary, secondary and tertiary winding. So all these are the associated disadvantages of three winding transformer. Is it clear, all of you? Yes. So this is all about what is that, three winding transformers. So in the examination, usually as per my knowledge, they will ask the question based on with an explain how tertiary winding can be used to achieve stabilization. Okay, but make sure that you need to study all these concepts. Don't practice only this concept. You should also see what are the requirements, because sometimes they may ask these questions also. Okay, so you be prepared for all the concepts related to three winding transformer, that is why to use tertiary winding, stabilization concept, equivalent circuit concept, then advantages and disadvantages. Is it clear, all of you? Do you have any doubts? Can you hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Till where I have explained to you, because here some network problem, because of that I am not aware of the things. Where I have stopped? Have I explained?
Advantages and disadvantages, sir.
Till disadvantage part is over, right? So now you tell me, shall I proceed the class or shall I wind up the class? Because the last topic of your transformer is cooling methods. It will take another half an hour. Or shall I explain in the next class?
The next class.
Okay.
Sir, shall we leave the meeting?